Hey, this is Eric Matisoff, and my role at Adobe is as the Global Evangelist for Analytics and Data Science. Today, I'm going to show you some of my favorite right-click tricks in order to speed up the way that you use Analysis Workspace. Let's jump in. The first place that I'll be starting is where a lot of analysis starts, and that's within a freeform table. Here you can see I've pulled in marketing channel as a dimension and a couple of metrics of online orders and unique visitors. The first right click trick that I'd like to teach you is the ability to just simply right click a metric like this and simply change the attribution model associated with that metric. Here you can pick and choose any of the pre-built or custom models that you have available to you. And you have the opportunity to adjust the custom lookback window as well, from visit to visitor, or even something custom as well. Once you click apply, you've got everything you need to continue your analysis thanks to the power of right-clicking. Now, if I undo that, I also, when I right-click, have the opportunity to compare an attribution model. This is where I could very quickly add a couple of extra columns in order to compare my first touch attribution model with the default last touch attribution model and receive a percent change all along the way. Now, another right-click power that I love so much is right-clicking on a metric in a freeform table and creating a metric from that selection. Now, you can very easily go ahead and select one of the pre-built functions here, like mean or median, the max, min, or sum. So we could click mean, for example. And once you do that, you'll receive in every row the value for the mean number of items associated with that metric. Now, if you select two calculated metrics at the same time, I just simply held down shift or command or control on a PC, and you can right click again. And you've got different options, divide, subtract, add, multiply, and percent change. Perhaps we want to see how far off the actual number of online orders is from the mean. Well, all it took was a couple of right clicks in order to make that happen. Now, the last metric that we could create is the opportunity to just simply say, you know what, open this up in the calculated metric builder. What I love about this sneaky little tip here is it automatically pulls in the metric at hand so that you don't have to instead click the metrics here, then find the metric that you're dealing with and drag and drop it. So it's a really nice little time saver, all thanks to just a simple right click. Now, the other items within a freeform table that may be of interest to you could be comparing time periods. Now, this is a feature that we've had for some time. You can choose to compare your time period to the prior 30 days or a custom date range, or simply add a time period column with the same options depending on the date settings within your panel. Yet another superpower capability associated with right-clicking is perhaps selecting some data within your freeform table, right-clicking, and copying that to your clipboard. You can then take that data and paste it anywhere you like, in email, Excel, even Twitter. The last feature that I love taking advantage of associated with right-clicking within a freeform table is creating an alert from this selection. You can see I have several marketing channels and metrics all selected, but when I pull up my create alert from my selection, you can see that each of them are pulled in and pre-built with an alert for me. So I can see all of the details associated with the options that I've selected in terms of the marketing channels and each of the metrics that I have pulled in to that table. It is a fantastic time saver when you are looking to create some alerts on the fly. Now, obviously, if you're creating alerts by right clicking, you can also, of course, go ahead and create a segment from your selection as well. Yet another huge time saver that I find myself using all the time. It's smart enough to recognize that if you have multiple dimensional items selected, to put an OR in between them so that you've got a segment that is providing you with the right set of data. Moving along from freeform tables, You may also find yourself performing some analysis within a flow visualization like the one that I have pulled up here. Now I've pulled in and started digging in just to some interesting analyses associated with my page dimension. Don't forget that you also have the opportunity to switch your dimension on the fly, but that's not why we're here. We're here to learn about some right clicking. So if I find an interesting path that I want to learn more about, I have the opportunity, yes, to right click and choose create a segment for this path, where once again, we're showing step by step by step by step everything that's going on within my path. Similarly, I can right click and choose to trend so I can see has the set of users going from the home page to the category one page to subcategory 1A, has that been increasing or decreasing over time? Now, there's one last item to consider here within a flow visualization, and that's the opportunity to break down any of these paths as well. That's by each of your different dimensions, metrics, segments, and date ranges. So a wealth of opportunity for you when right-clicking within a flow visualization. Moving along to Fallout, you're going to see some very familiar concepts. We can choose any step along the way within our Fallout visualization. And again, we can choose to trend, break down, or create segments just simply by right-clicking. I won't go through all of them since you just saw me perform those actions within my flow. Now, the last two pieces of right-click tips that I have for you are right-clicking right within a visualization. So we have the opportunity here to simply duplicate this visualization. Perhaps I wanted to switch a visualization and have it side by side, but I wanted to start with the same few steps. I can do that just simply by right-clicking. Similarly, I find myself doing this all the time with a freeform table. Duplicate visualization, and now I can sit them side by side with just a little bit of resizing. Perhaps over here, I add some segments or change the metrics, etc. Now you also will have this option at the panel level. This is what I really love. Duplicate my panel. So it takes every single visualization within my panel. And from here, I can then even change my report suite so that I've got the same sets of visualizations, but side by side across two different report suites. This one focused on my mobile app, and this one focused on the website. Now, the very last item that I like to recommend in terms of right-clicking, you'll see within the left rail. Over here, you can choose any metric or dimension or segment in order to tag, favorite, or approve any of those components. This is a great way to keep your implementation and your report suite nice and organized and well governed. Within any calculated metrics, you can also choose to share or delete them, and the same should come with segments that you've created as well, the opportunity to share or delete them. I hope you find that these right-click tips can really speed up your ability to tap into the data that lives within Analysis Workspace in Adobe Analytics. Remember, when in doubt, just simply right-click. Thank you.